Welcome to Jung Tuition. I am Jung. A good news first. I will make more talks for the general public who are interested in weather change and climate stability. So hopefully more people from different backgrounds or age groups could come and become my subscribers. Today, I'd like to discuss some commonly concerned issues on weather and climate nowadays. Of course, I will continue to discuss basic issues in climate research from time to time for students and researchers only. It's common sense to think of climate as kind of the averaged weather, such as the mean temperature and the precipitation of the particular month or decade. In these ways, it would appear a regional climate is determined by its weather. On the other hand, attempts have been made to calculate the global mean surface temperature or the air temperature near the surface by building a climate model. It would appear that local weather patterns should be dependent of such climate prediction. It sounds like a relation between chickens and eggs. Let's talk about this today. So are you ready? I mean, to like, to share, and to subscribe, as well as to make your little bell activated so that you will not miss any of my talks. Okay, let's go and have fun. Nowadays, it would appear many people have been psychologically programmed to attribute any unexpected or extreme weather phenomena to climate change due to CO2, especially when the event has brought up with property or human losses. Both Tim Palmer and Sabine Hossenfelder seem to agree to each other on this issue, but is this reasonable? To facilitate our discussion, it is necessary to describe both weather and climate in terms of physics, geology, and general circulation in the atmosphere. First, what is weather? Weather refers to local and temperature-related changes, such as a sunny or rainy days. But why does weather change? That is because the atmosphere can hardly reach a perfect thermal equilibrium due to uneven radiation from the sun and complicated responses from the surface and the fluid dynamical atmosphere. But this is just part of the story. As surface creatures, people often complain unexpected bad weathers as if the weather should change according to their desires. Why? Because the radiation from the sun is uneven, as I just mentioned. The Earth has been trying very hard to restore its thermal equilibrium for its survival in the universe. That's to say, weather changes irrespective of whether you love it or hate it. Of course, if you only pay attention to bad weathers, you would eventually feel down and have a miserable face, as Tim Palmer does. Actually, I thought Tim looks like the actor for Antonia in the main chart for Venus.
No. Well, then you're in love.
Fie.
In essence, weather is unrandom and hence unpredictable in a long run, caused by a number of random variables. Hence, it is illogical to attribute a weather event to a single reason, such as the global mean surface temperature. Bear in mind, it is unreliable to measure the so-called global mean surface temperature. Such a mean temperature is completely useless for weather forecasting because the variation in the surface temperature differs from one area to another at a different latitude, geological properties, and water content. With advent of the computer-assisted weather forecasting, known as a numerical weather prediction, NWP, one can predict about 1 week in advance the time-dependent distributions of those weather variables using the present observation as the initial conditions. As first shown by Lawrence, nevertheless, the onset of chaos seems inevitable as the time duration increases for NWP, indicating deterministic solutions are unlikely. Influenced by the maximum entropy principle defined in information theory, Tim Palmer has been obsessed by using so-called ensemble forecast for numerical weather prediction. That's to say, running many weather models with a slightly different initial conditions. In doing so, he must have defied the second law in thermodynamics, which I will discuss soon. Second, what is climate? In common sense, climate is related to the mean of the long-term weather patterns in a particular area or region, such as the mean temperature or precipitation in a particular month or season. Clearly, climate is also location dependent. In fact, it is meaningless to talk about a global climate, similar to use a single global mean for the so-called surface temperature anomaly. Since 1896, it has been argued that the mean surface temperature could be predicted by using a climate model at different CO2 concentrations in the atmosphere. Next time, I will show you how Arrhenius made some terrible mistakes in doing so. Around 1900, the notion of the greenhouse effect appeared in literature. In particular, an imbalance in outgoing long wave radiation at the top of atmosphere due to CO2 doubling close to 3.7 watt per meter square is calculated by many authors. But such an imbalance is too weak to affect numerical weather forecast for a week or so. Tim Palmer and others should know this, but they still claim that numerical weather forecast software can be used to evaluate the long-term climate sensitivity given by a climate model. Tim Palmer might have relied on the maximum entropy principle in information theory to work out the most probable ensemble prediction, but his expectation for a large climate sensitivity, say over 5K, is inconsistent with the increased entropy principle implied in the second law of thermodynamics. How? Because by definition, entropy change can be written as the absorbed heat by a system divided by its thermal temperature in Kelvin, as shown here. Obviously, the higher the temperature or the higher the climate sensitivity, the less entropy change atmosphere surface system would be. What would happen? The atmospherical surface system would spontaneously and by all means keep the surface temperature in order to maximize his entropy. It is evident that Tim Palmer has been confused with two different entropies. One is defined in the information theory, another is in thermodynamics. Still, can instantaneous radiation by CO2 affect the weather patterns in your area at all? The answer is absolutely not. Why? Because the observed temperature distributions have taken all thermodynamical processes into account, including thermal radiation. In general, local weather changes are part of the general circulation, which is global and constantly affected by the difference in temperature and hence pressure in the atmosphere. In particular, the temperature differences between the equator and the poles. Here is a relevant paragraph from the paper by R. Sisters, published in 1960. Radiative cooling is not usually strong enough to affect the local weather over a relatively short period. But he also considered radiation as a secondary source of the heating for the global warming, Why didn't Tim and Sabina tell their audience if they knew? In summary, unexpected or extreme weather phenomena can hardly be attributed to a hypothetical global mean surface temperature. The real reason for different weather events are due to endless efforts made by the Earth to reduce temperature and pressure gradients in the troposphere in order to maximize its total entropy. It would appear both Tim Palmer and Sabine Hossenfelder have failed to understand the origin of the nonlinear dynamics in the atmosphere Tim has studied since the 1970s. Thank you for watching. Thank you for donation. See you next time.